Hello everyone. In this video, we will study the third problem of ABC 320. Here is a slot machine, three wheels, and each of the wheel has a train S. Its length is M, and each time Takahashi can add choose and press one button. Okay, now here we can see the sample. The first line is the length of the trains, and the second, the third, the fourth line are three trains. For the first sample, here the length is 10, and if we want to have the number 1, here we press 0 and press here is T is 0 1, and here is 7. So max 0 1 0 7. The result is 7, and we get the number 1 on all of the three wheels. And if we want to get the number 2, here is the number 2, so and here is the number 2, max 9 2 0. So the answer is 9, and if we want to get number 3, here is 2, and it's 7, and it's 0, it's 1. So we can enumerate all the numbers from 0 to 9, and finally we can find the number of 0. Has the minimum seconds. For 0, here is no 8, not 0, 8. Here is 6, and 8. The second line 0, and the third line 2. So 6 is the minimum possible number of second. So finally, we output 6, and if we want to get other numbers like 4, 5, 6, the number will be greater than 6. Okay. Now let's study the second sample. The second sample. The length is 20. So here we integer t seconds. So if we want to get these three zeros, the first zero, the time is 0, and for the second zero, the time is 20. It's one period. And for the third zero, the time is 40 is the second period. So the answer is 40. Okay. Now we notice that here is another zero. If we take this zero, and this zero, okay. For the first zero, we use zero time, and for the second zero, it's in the tens position, so the number is 10. For the last zero, because we press the first line at the first second, so we need to press 0 plus m is 20, okay. Now we also can try the number of 1. Here, this 31, the max number is 21 equals 1 plus 20, and 41 equals 1 plus 220s. And if we want to get this one and this one and this one, the answer is 1, 11, and 21. Okay, now we can see that the minimum possible number is 20. And if we want to get the other number, like 2, 3, or 4, or any other numbers, the time will be greater than 20. So the answer is 20. Okay, now we can see the last sample. The last sample, here are no same number in all the three lines. So the answer is minus 1. It's impossible to get the same number in all of the three reals. Okay. So because here are only three lines and the maximum of m is 100. So if we take three loops, the time will be one million. So it will be calculated soon. So we can write three loops. And the first loop to find the number in the S1, and the second loop for the S2, the last loop for the last train. Okay, now let's code. Here, the first line, M, and here are three trains. Okay, four, if S1i is not the same as S2j, continue. For example, here one i is 0, we get the number 1, and one j is 0, we get the number 8. Because 1 is not equal to 8, we don't need to consider the last number, so we can go to the next. The next is 1. Okay, both are the number of 1, so we can enumerate the last string. So here we can continue to improve the efficiency. 4. Okay, if all the numbers are the same, okay. Now we can calculate the max time. The max time and then now we need free variable temp I, temp k. Okay, if I no, if s one I is equal to the s two j, like this. Here, S1i is 0 and S2j is also 0. So we need to plus m in this, in the second line. No, here is I the position of the string, not the value of the string. Temp j, okay. And if I is equal to k, like this one, I is equal to k. So temp k plus m. Now so this is the new temperature and this is the new temperature. Now here we can see that they are at the same position. So we need to plus again. J is equal to k, or temperature is equal to temperature, and the temperature k need to plus again. Okay, now we also can see this situation, this case. Here I is 0, so temp I is 0, and here j is 10, so temp j is 10, and here k is 0. If okay, this condition is true, so temp k will be 0 plus 20. Okay, now we get the value of temp k as 20. J is 10 and k is, now k is 0, so okay. Finally, we can get the max. Here is max temp I and temp j. Temp j and temp k. Here we get the maximum number of the three numbers. Okay. Ans is mean now we can, here we can define the ans int max, okay. Finally, we output ans if ans never be changed, then the answer will be -1, and otherwise output the answer. Okay, now let's test here for the last sample. The answer is correct, and for the second answer, 20 is okay, and for the first case, 6. Okay, now we can submit this code to the website here. Okay, so we can see the solution is not difficult. In order to solve this problem, we only use three loops. C, okay, so because int max is defined in the C limits header file, so we need to change the file header file. Okay. Oh, bits. Now we can submit again. Okay, the solution is accepted. And now this task is finished, and see you next time.